Very good morning to you all the students. Here, well, I am Rajneesh. I have been the assigned for the COI Constitution of the India. Here, my topic is the silent feature and the characteristic of the Indian Constitution. Today, I am delivering lecture for the part one. Before it, I also discussed about the silent feature and the characteristic of the Indian Constitution. In that period, you taught so many points I discussed earlier. Today, I have to discuss on a fourth point. Number one, preamble. Number second, the parliament form of the democracy. Number third, independent body. And number four, that is the finally, that is the quasi-federal but the unity. Here, I am starting with the preamble. Basically, the preamble is basically a soul of the Constitution. Here, the real meaning of the preamble is, it is nothing, it is simply a proposal. If you write a letter, whatever you write, if you write some departmental letter, you are writing a subject. What is the subject? Subject is nothing. It is simply a gist of your total letter. If you are drafting or writing a book, in an introduction or in a preface, what you do? You are trying to give the basic sum up of your written things in the same manner for the Constitution. This is basically a preamble. Here, in the Indian Constitution, consider this body means the Swaraj, Socialist, Secular, Democratic and the Republic as a very important pillars, edifies of the Indian Constitution. I am starting with the Swaraj. The real sense of the Swaraj is the absolutely independent, means whatever the system is the running on here, no doubt we are under so many rules and the regulations and the compulsions. But we are absolutely independent. We are basically free to do anything, but that should be well within the legitimate right. Means practically around 70% we are independently. We are independent. Point two, here, the socialist. Basically, India is a democratic country. Here, the group, the committee who conceived the idea of the Constitution, they had also the known and the fact in their mind that India is basically a democratic country, and along with the equitable distribution of the wealth, means the wealth must be allocated, distributed more and less equally among all, because there is a very great gap between the wealthy people and the deprived one. So it is not a practically possible, it will take a very great deal of time. So, the real sense is there, no concentration of the wealth. Wealth should not be flowed. Wealth should not be directed to a single class or a single party or a single group or a single inhabitant or a single premium class. So, the wealth must be on the mode of the equitable distribution. That is why the India is basically a socialist as well as a capitalist country. I have also written here. Then after the secular means the country, the state itself having no religion. You may be a follower and of the practice of the so many religions individually. One has to respect. There is a low compulsion. There is a low force that you have to be follow your religious and the spiritual practice only and the only in this way. There is nothing like so, especially in India. India is truly in a very secular country. None is and full is free to obey, to
follow to spread peace to their believers. So the state do not have the interest.
No religion for the state citizen are forced to follow and the practice of the religion of his and the her trust. The state cannot discriminate among the citizens on the basis of the religion. On the basis of the religion, you cannot be select and you cannot be believed.
Here, the democratic. Very simple. The democratic is something very simple. The power has been vested in the really in the hand of the citizen. And all the citizens enjoy the equal political right.
Here, the finally, that is the republic.
India is basically a republic country, indirectly elected MLA, MP, Mukhiya, even in the Gram Panchayat, Chief President, PM, Jury. So, the election is a very important part. Especially in the democratic country,
there is no candidate and there is no power by the part, especially in the democratic structure part that India is having.
Here, the second independent point I am discussing here, the parliament form a democracy here. The democracy is running. But the form and the feature of the democracy, especially running in the India, is the parliament form a democracy. Here, the president is the nominal part of the state and the nation, no doubt. The honor, regards, and the respect of the president is in the democracy on the apex degree. But it has been the very nominal part. At the time of the exigency and the emergency, only that the real power of the emergency. Nation can experience by the respecting of your fundamental and religion. I've already discussed about the things. And sub part, the real head is the PM. Basically, the Prime Minister is the real head, and the Council of the Minister is also. And the Council of the Minister are the really responsible for the Lok Sabha. Here, that's why the India form of the democracy only believes, and it is the only place that is the parliament. Independent body. In India, we have a very independent body where there is no interference of the Council of the Minister and the elected member. We have a 100% independent body, like the EC, Election Commission, the article as 324. Here, the CAG, Comptroller of the Auditor General, the article 148, and UPSC, the IAS, IPSC, the Union Public Service Commission, article 1-3. There are so many things, so on. And finally, we are here with the quasi-federal world, the unity. The real means of the quasi is the half. Basically, India is a half-federal and a half-unitary country. If the parliament dissolves the two-thirds of the state majority, and the two-thirds of the central majority, means this is the central majority in the parliament. That is why India's quasi half federal world unitary government is the enjoying a very strong and very effective decision making process in the Indian constitution. So in this manner, I am finishing the silent feature and the characteristics of the Indian constitution. But for you, just I am recapping again. The silent feature of the characteristic of the Indian Constitution COI part 1, the preamble is a soul of the Constitution. As you know, the Constitution is a gateway of the political activity, and whereas the Constitution is a gateway of the political activity, and whereas the political parties are the windows of the constitution and partition. Here,
the preamble is the added with the five important points. That's why preamble is nothing. It is simply,
this is the advance written in the constitution. Because this sort of the sense you will find in the every article and the every schedule, every read. Every appendix here, the sovereignty absolutely independent, socialist equal distribution of the socio-economic effort, secular, there is no foundation and there is no force for the religion, democratic finally elected and the republic indirectly elected, there is no hierarchy, monarchy. Second, the parliament form of the democracy here, the PM and the Council of Ministers is the one of the most functional, powerful head, and the president is the nominal head. It is headed body, we have the election commissioner, he can article 324, tag controller of the auditor general article 148, and whereas the UPSC article 155, and the finally the quasi center of the unitary government India has the means of the quasi is the half. If the parliament is scoring with the two-third majority, and the state is also earned with the two-third majority, it means the simple majority. That's why the India is the quasi, means half failure of what the unitary government. In this way, I am finishing my work, and today I am closing my class. For the next topic, we will discuss. And we need this is a very important chapter. This is basically a gold mine for your, not only for your faculty examination, for your upcoming examination. If you are going to be appear in the examination of the IPOS, even the GAT, even the IAS, IPS, banks, and whatever the upcoming examination, this area COI is the gold mine for that. In the meantime, I am closing my discourse.